Hello friends, welcome back. I am Neha Paryani. In today's session, we will discuss about depreciation. So let's begin.
Depreciation. Let's try to understand the concept of depreciation in detail. The term depreciation refers to permanent, continuing and gradual shrinkage in the book value of fixed asset. Here it means that depreciation refers to the continuous reduction in the book value of the fixed asset. Okay, let's take an example. Assume that we have purchased any fixed asset like machinery. Okay, we have purchased machinery in the year 2016 by paying rupees 3 lakh. Okay, then we go on using the machinery for the production purpose. Okay, and after some years when you want to sell the machinery, like in 2018, you want to sell the machinery. Then, will you get the same amount which you paid for purchasing it? That is rupees 3 lakh? No, right? Its value will be reduced. Due to continuous usage, the machinery will be second-hand machinery, right? The value which you will get after its sale will not be equal to the book value. There will be reduction in the book value. That we call it as depreciation, okay? And depreciation is continuous. The value of the asset keeps on decreasing every year. Okay, so depreciation is a continuous process. You may use the fixed asset or you may not use the fixed asset. Once you have purchased it, its value goes on decreasing, right? But in some cases, the value of the fixed asset may increase. That is in case of land and buildings. Right? When you resell your land or buildings, the value of those will be increased. You will get more value than the original cost. That we call it as appreciation. Okay? If the value of the fixed asset is increased year by year, then we call it as appreciation. And if the value of the fixed asset is decreased year by year, that we call it as depreciation. Okay? Are you clear? Here we will discuss about depreciation. So now the question arises, what can be the causes for depreciation? So they are wear and tear due to usage of asset. So as I said earlier, as we go on using the asset, there are many chances that the parts of the assets may get damaged, right? So due to that, the value of the machine, the value of the fixed asset will get reduced or depreciated. Okay, next. Effect of time, or you can also say it as efflux of time. So as the time passes on, we may or may not use the fixed asset, the value of it will go on reducing. Okay, then third, accidents. So if in case our fixed asset meets with any type of accidents, its value will gradually decrease. Okay, then obsolescence. Here obsolescence means outdated. So when our product becomes outdated or it becomes obsolete, then the value of fixed asset will decrease, right? So this mainly happens in case of technological products or electronic products. When the new model of the same product enters into the market, the value of the old asset will gradually decrease, right? So obsolescence is one of the main reasons for depreciation. Okay, so now the question arises, is there a need for charging the depreciation, or do we have to show it in the books of accounts? Yes, right? So the reasons for charging depreciation could be matching of costs and revenues. So we know that as per matching concepts, the cost and revenue of a particular period should be matched, right? So by considering matching concept, we charge depreciation. Okay, then consideration of tax. So when we charge depreciation on the assets, then we have to pay lesser tax. Okay, so as a part of tax planning, depreciation is charged. Then true and fair financial position. So by charging the depreciation, we can ascertain the correct value of the fixed asset. Then when the correct value of the fixed asset is mentioned in the balance sheet, then it will obviously show the true and fair financial position, right? And if in case we do not charge the depreciation in the books of accounts, the value of the fixed assets will be overvalued, right? Then it may not show the true and fair, it may show the false financial position of the business organization. Okay, then ascertaining cost of the product. So as I said, if we want to know the exact value of the product on a particular date, it can be known only after charging the depreciation. Okay, so these are the reasons why we need to charge the depreciation. Now let's discuss about the factors affecting the amount of depreciation. So when we know that we have to charge depreciation on the asset, we cannot randomly decide the amount of depreciation that needs to be charged, right? For example, when we have purchased a machinery amounting rupees 3 lakh, we cannot charge the depreciation of rupees 1 lakh or 1,50,000 per year, right? So there are certain factors which affect the amount of depreciation or which helps in deciding the amount of depreciation that needs to be charged every year. Okay, so the determination of depreciation depends on three parameters. They are cost, estimated useful life, and probable salvage value. So let's try to understand these terms in detail. Okay, so the first factor or the first term which affects the amount of depreciation is cost of asset. So it is obvious, right? So according to you, what could be the cost of the asset? It may refer to the price which we paid for purchasing that asset, right? But here in this case, it is not only purchase price, but it also includes various costs. So they are freight and transportation cost, transit insurance, installation costs, and registration cost. So here it is not only purchase price, okay? So basically it includes all those costs which are incurred for the first time or which are necessary for putting that asset in a working condition. Okay, for example, assume that you have purchased different parts of machinery. Okay, then you need to use that machinery for production purpose. So when you bring those parts and keep it in your godown, will it work? No, right? You will have to assemble all the parts and you will have to install the machinery in your godown or production unit, right? Then we will incur certain costs that will also be added in the purchase price, that will also be treated as cost of asset. Okay, so here remember that cost of asset does not only mean purchase price, but it also includes all the costs which are necessary for putting that asset into a working condition. Okay, then if in case we purchase a second hand asset, then it will also include initial repair cost. So whatever the repairs which are necessary for again for putting that asset into a working condition, they are also added in the cost of asset. Okay, are we clear? Next factor is estimated net residual value. So residual value is also called as scrap value or salvage value. Okay, you need to remember this: scrap value or salvage value. So net residual value is nothing but the sale value of the asset at the end of its useful life. So when the life of the asset ends or when it cannot be used for manufacturing or it is not in the working condition, the value that it has on that particular period of time is known as sale value or net residual value. Okay, the net residual value is calculated after deducting the expenses necessary for disposal of the asset. So if in case there are any expenses incurred for disposing that asset, even those expenses should be deducted from, only after that we can estimate the residual value or sale value of that asset. Okay, clear? Next, estimated useful life. So here useful life refers to the time period for which that product is working or that asset is in working condition. Okay, so hence economic and commercial life of the asset is important here. Physical life is not important because the machinery, you can see it for many years, but it is either in the working condition or not, that is important. Okay, so hence estimated useful life of the product is also a factor which affects the amount of depreciation. Okay, now up to now we have learnt about the Meaning of depreciation, that is nothing but the continuous reduction in the value of asset, causes for depreciation, reasons for charging depreciation, and also factors affecting amount of depreciation. Okay, then let's talk about the methods of charging depreciation. Okay, there are various methods in which the depreciation can be charged, but the most common methods that are used are straight line method and written down value method. Okay, so let's try to understand these. Straight line method of depreciation. According to this method, a fixed and an equal amount is charged as depreciation in every accounting period during the lifetime of an asset. So when we are following the straight line method of charging depreciation, then a fixed and an equal amount or the same amount of depreciation is charged for every accounting period during the lifetime of an asset. For example, lifetime of an asset is for 10 years. Okay, so same amount of depreciation, assume that rupees 10,000 is charged every year for the 10 years as well. Okay, so the amount will not change. Okay, so this is also called as fixed installment method because fixed amount of depreciation is charged, right? So you need to remember the synonyms for this. Straight line method is also known as fixed installment method. Okay, so for calculating the depreciation, there is a formula. So depreciation is calculated for the first year and the same amount of depreciation is charged for all the years. Again, you need not calculate the depreciation for every year. Okay, so the formula is cost of asset minus scrap value divided by estimated life. So while discussing the factors, we saw three parameters, right? They are nothing but cost of asset, estimated residual value or scrap value or salvage value, and estimated useful life. So all these three are used here. Okay, cost of asset minus scrap value, also known as residual value, divided by estimated life. Okay, so when we use this formula, we can calculate the depreciation for an year. Okay, then if we want to calculate the rate or percentage of depreciation for 1 year per annum, then we should use the formula, that is annual depreciation amount divided by cost of asset into 100. So here we get to know the annual depreciation amount, right? The amount that we get or the amount of depreciation that we get after using this formula, that is nothing but annual depreciation amount. Okay, when the cost of asset is divided by annual depreciation amount and into 100, because it is percentage, right? So we need to use into 100, then we get the rate of depreciation for 1 year. Okay, so let's try to understand this with an example. A business purchased a van with the following details. So purchase price of the van is rupees 14,000 and delivery fee is rupees 2,000. So earlier I told you, right, it is not only purchase price, but it also involves all the transportation costs, installation costs, etc. So delivery fee should also be the part of the cost of the asset, right? So we need to add it here. Then estimated useful life is 4 years and estimated residual or scrap value is rupees 6,400. So when we use this formula, we will get depreciation amount is equal to, so price of the product or the cost of the product would be rupees 14,000 plus 2,000, that is 16,000. Right, remember, don't take it only as 14,000. Okay, add the delivery fee as well in the cost. Rupees 16,000 minus scrap value or residual value that is given is rupees 6,400. Right, so deduct it, rupees 6,400 divided by estimated life of an asset, that is 4 years. Right, 4 years. So when we calculate this, we get 16,000 minus 6,400 would be rupees 9,600 divided by 4. Rupees 2,400 is the amount of depreciation that needs to be charged. Okay, rupees 2400. Then when we want to calculate the depreciation percentage for 1 year, for per annum, that would be depreciation percentage. So the formula is annual depreciation amount that we calculated just now, right? That is rupees 2400 divided by cost of an asset. Cost of an asset is rupees 16,000, right? 14,000 plus 2,000, 16,000 into 100. Because we want to know the percentage, we need to use into 100, okay? So the rate of depreciation that we get is rupees 2,400 divided by 16,000 into 100 is 15%, okay? So this is how you calculate the amount of depreciation and the rate of depreciation under straight line method. Second method is written down value method. Under this method, depreciation is charged on the book value of the asset. Such book value keeps on reducing by the annual charge of depreciation. So the amount of depreciation on asset goes on diminishing year by year. See here in this case, the amount of depreciation that we charge is on the book value of the asset, not on the original cost of the asset. Okay. Now what is this term called book value? So it is nothing but the value of the asset that we get after charging the depreciation. You will understand this term after you have a look at this example. Okay. Right now you understand that depreciation under written down value method is charged on the book value and not on the original cost. Okay, so this is the main difference between the straight line method and written down value method. In straight line method, depreciation is charged on original cost. Here it is charged on book value. Okay, and the depreciation here in this case, the amount of depreciation here in this case will go on diminishing every year. Okay, and in written down value method, it is same for all the years, right? But here it will go on decreasing. Hence, it is also known as diminishing balance method. So that is the synonym word for written down value method. Okay, you need to remember this. Written down value method is also known as diminishing balance method. In examination, it can be asked either calculate depreciation as per written down value method or diminishing balance method. So you should not get confused. Both are same. Okay. Now let's have a look at this example. The original cost of asset is rupees 2 lakh and depreciation is charged at 10% per annum at written down value. Okay. Then the amount of depreciation is as follows. For the first year, depreciation would be rupees on 2 lakh, that is on the original cost, we have to charge 10% of depreciation. So 10% of 2 lakh would be rupees 20,000, right? So when we deduct rupees 20,000 from 2 lakh, we will get certain value. That value is nothing but book value. That will be at the end of the first year. We charge depreciation at the end of the year, right? So when we deduct the depreciation amount from the original cost, then we get the book value of the asset, that is rupees 1,80,000 at the end of first year. Okay, then in the second year, when you want to charge the depreciation, you should charge 10% not on rupees 2 lakh, not on the original cost. Okay, you need to charge 10% on the book value. So for depreciation for second year would be 10% on 1,80,000, right? That is rupees 18,000. So again, when you deduct rupees 18,000 from rupees 1,80,000, that would be 1,64,000, right? 62,000. So this is nothing but the book value of the asset at the end of second year. Again, when you calculate depreciation for third year, you will have to calculate 10% on rupees 1,62,000. Not on 1,80,000 or not on 2 lakh. Okay, so hence, see, the amount of depreciation for first year was rupees 20,000, then it reduced to 18,000, then at the third year it will be rupees 16,200. It is going on diminishing, right? But the rate of depreciation is same, that is 10% for every year. So in case if the amount of depreciation goes on decreasing and the rate remains same, then it is called as written down value method. And if in case the amount of depreciation is same for every year, that is here, see, in this case, in the straight line method, ₹2,400 will be charged for all the years for its useful life, that is 4 years. The amount will not be changed, but here in this case it is going on diminishing, right? Hence this is the difference between straight line method and written down value method. Okay, I hope you understood. So this was just a small example on calculating the depreciation using these methods. But in your examination, you will be asked to prepare a separate asset account as well as depreciation account. So you will get problems like those in your examination. So those problems we will solve in my upcoming sessions. Okay, so please don't forget to watch my next sessions as well.
Hey guys, so this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. You can ask me any questions in the comment section below. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.